We have a lot of Na'Vi fanboys over on our page, so
could explain a little bit more.
Vanskor's gonna have a bit of a quick check. Yeah, Vanskor.
30 seconds.
What is he doing? Is he trying to drag him? I think he's trying to drag him down.
It might be better just to build up all Funic. Anchor smash. The Whirling Death doesn't care about that. Level 2, in fact. Bottom lane. Oh, they get the leash on Cheshire Cat. Vanskor. Gonna wait until he can follow up with the stun. We'll go back and heal. Oh, nice and snare in Cheshire Cat. The Living Armor, though, is still protecting Denny. The Stomp to follow up. It's going to hold Denny in position. He doesn't have 6 charges available. Vanskor arrives a little bit too late, but Nagasaren, they're going to get hexed up and take a lot of damage from the tower. The Wisp basic attacker still 62 points of damage. Wait, is that a relocate? Yeah, it is. Jumping towards the middle lane, they go on Dendy. Denny's got the buckler flying in right now, and he almost killed off Sinido. He's so low on life. Vanskor rotates in. Cheshire Cat will now take a fall. The relocate will pull him back in just a moment, and there she goes. But a failed gank coming in. In fact, Tidehunter waited for him up on the top to kill off the Wisp. And what are we going to get? Bounty Rune, so more into the bottle of a Vorst. And they know Sinido is there. Dark Pact, he's going to blink up. There's your instant damage, then into the leech, holding the Wisp in position. He'll tick out anyway. Doesn't matter what happened there with the tether up. While up on top lane, that Ravage, it's not available for Funic. He's short of the mana. Now he's actually got it. Even after, he didn't even have to use the stick charges for that. So Cheshire Cat into the tree lines, another leech over here onto J4. Multicast, but not enough to really control anything. While Cheshire Cat hiding in the tree line, Funic can't find him. He might be concerned too, the Cheshire Cat. Yeah, she can't TP out. He only TP'd up towards the top lane. Fairly certain Na'Vi will be aware of that too. So he'll stomp, FNG, Leech Seek, gonna give it all the life points back. Yeah. They even stick around to enjoy the extra life leech. And they take the tier. And the Viper is also getting even more cocky. BKB this time will be purchased up by Dendy. He goes up to high ground, the Viper strikes, trying to keep J4 down, and then again, he can just kill J4 right now. One more attack and J4 is toast. The Meg Charge will trigger, more supports coming in right now for Na'Vi. Of course, they'll try and tether and chase after Dendy. The ball's hitting him pretty hard, and then Vanskor only stuns over on the illusions. And then the Hex, it'll actually mean that you can't get the pullback on the Shark Room straight away. Dendy, the Spirit, won't be able to reach him either. Nice Timber Chain with Whirling Death. A lot of bonus damage into Na'Vi there. But a blink to Ravage, he wants the death of Nagasaren, and a kill secure coming out from Vanskor. Wanted the kill before this kind of stuff could happen. Shashlo diving into the T1 tower. He's got his reactive armor charges at maximum at the moment. A Vorst right behind him. He wants to pounce control to Funic. Being dragged down to double kill for this Timbersaw. Of course, that puts a big bounty on his head right now, and a Vorst will take it from him. Like, Funic is actually going to be I'm not going to say mech man, because the mech's already done. They're trying to build into a pipe at the moment. Now, multicast, but blinks into the tree line. Vanskor, a blind stun, going to miss. He's still going to get hit by this Wisp balls and goes down for Nagasaren. Ending a killing spree. The ET splitter will clean up the tree line. Not to mention the Timbersaw cutting through it. He knows the Funic's going to be in the corner. Thought he might have been TPing out. Funic, how quickly can you blink the Chakram? Oh, I think they don't know where he is. He's in the tree line. He doesn't blink out. Anchor smash, 5 seconds until Ravage. TP support. It was coming as he ends up being cancelled. He didn't come in the whole way. Funic, the Ravage will pop. TP, can you do it, Funic? He blinks. He's running. Denny will come in. He'll actually give cover fire. Cheshire Cat ticking down very, very low. The relocate. You got no Ravage. Surprised Na'Vi are trying to force this. Like, Shashlo is the primary man. He's BKBs as well. Timber Chain's through, Vanskor, he is so toast. Sharkram comes back off cooldown. That ulti from FNG. Oh, they found they found the Naga. That's bigger. A Vorst, Vanskor here. Finger of Death gonna be committed. And that was just into the extra damage from the Dark Pack. They also managed to catch out Sinido. He's trying to relocate himself out, but looks like got interrupted. And a Vorst still able to chat. Coming up inside the jungle, a Vorst just leaves himself away. They want the tower down, it's in deny range. And they have to let it go. There's 4 heroes from Power Rangers, and they don't have their Tidehunter there. But then again, J4, out a long way. A Vorst will pounce in again. He focuses on this Wisp. He wants the buff up hero gone, and he got him too. Now the tree ulti, holding a position. Shashlo, that BKB, most of it being wasted. While then he sends in his own BKB. Naga triggers the sleep as the BKBs wore off. Na'Vi have to wait. Vanskor trying to inch himself forward. The tower still not being denied. The stomp holding a Vorst in position. Let's party for a moment. The Stomp only just controlling Dendy. But you got FNG looking and waiting. The BKB jumping from the Timbersaw. Sharkram will go for the plant from Funic. Gives the protection they require. Shashlo up and towards the high ground. Again, the splitter being used. He chains across, multicast onto FNG, but a force pounces straight away. He won these supports. He couldn't get the leash off. Another three men stomp, but a force. The Mjolnir proc caught him out. Vanskor jumped up and found the Timbersaw on the high ground. Keeps the Suns going. They need more control. Finger of Death. He'll chain himself down, but he's right next to Funnic. The Anchor Smash range will actually end up killing him off. Two Observer Wards up. Avor's being watched so closely, but still, he's able to reach Cheshire Cat. Don't put the shark from. He had no real choice anyway, but the lightning proc was going to hurt him. And he's still got Shadow Dance in the Aegis Immortal, but he's trying to pounce up. He got him! The leech! Sharkshot didn't go all the way up. And now the tether's going to come in. Avor's Aegis Immortal would be triggered already. Sure, he picked up the ET. He'll be able to blink himself away to safety. That Whirling Death coming just a fraction of a second too late. And look at him run. As quick as he can. The Observer Ward will scout out Sinnito, just sitting inside the jungle, right next to, again, the Timbersaw, who chained himself away, which allowed for the pull down, but then he's BKB, protecting him, and then FNG. Dendi, he still wants to back up. The Nagasaur and ulti is gone. The Sharkrun will fly up. Dendi, actually now be controlled up by the sleep, and Avor pounces himself in, gets the leash of the Nagasaur. He doesn't have Shadow Dance available, throws away his life. Beyond Godlike Street taken by the Nagasaur. 851 gold for that one. And then they go. They do, of course, have Tide Ravage. That's nice. But to find this Nagasaur out. Actually, if they claim her gem, it's probably even bigger. Now, they're smoked up, so she doesn't get any kind of detection for this one. And then the tree line. The Hex, the Ravage. They need the Earth Spike, and then into a drain from Vanskor. He needs to get this mana up, but he's got enough for the Finger of Death. He'll use it on the Nagasaur. Needed a dead before she got the sleep off. And now they're able to go over to the Wisp. That's a really, really big kill right there for Na'Vi. Wouldn't have been possible if PR couldn't defend that tier 3 tower without her buyback. In fact, wow, okay. I think Jenny's just like, wait, this is a real one, guys. This is definitely a real one. Funnic, Ravish number 1 with the Anchor Smash. Refresher into Ravish number 2. And Wisp, he actually got interrupted. He tried to relocate save, and again, it's going to be a double kill on the back of a felon relocate save. Funny blinks in for the body block. He was BKB'd up, was the only thing he could do to stop him, but now Vanskor, he's got his son available, Finger of Death, and throws everything they've got. Funny is on a killing spree. The spirit will go down. Cheshire Cat's keeping himself away to safety. Escape from vision for a moment there. They give him the living armor too. Got earn charges, noob. Top tower has fallen. There's top racks, they're working through it quickly. Avor's taking the ranger rack solo. Now Timbersaw jumps in, BKB, there's only 5 seconds duration. Lickin' Sphere triggered off by J4, and then Avor beats in. Look how hard he's hitting! The BKB will trigger. He's trying to again chase down into the Wisp. Will Dark Pack try and break free? You can't break free in that Earthbind, however, and then just TP's out under the cover is BKB and Naga sleep. It was the only controller ability they had left, but the full double ranking is being completed here by Na'Vi. How many heroes will they lose on the way out? That's the only last remaining question. Relocate up, and then a double stun coming in from Vanskor, holding Sinnito in position. And Dendi, he just turns and brings him down. The BKB to pop him, but Dendi's still walking around with his butterfly. The tree ulti from FNG, and he cannot TP himself out of this one. Just trying to buy some more space. The Radiant's tick out, so she's going to kill him here. But it took a while to get the kill at the end. And he also wants to buy that Monkey King bar of his. Leap, pounce up, he got him. Naga sleeps. At the same time initiated with a Dark Pact. There's no Shadow Dance, there's ET split up. Get Vanskor and Dendi back in again, but Funnic, the first Ravage will go. Vanskor's already on the sidelines right now, but the second Ravage from Funnic, it really made it so Power Range could never get the support back in again. And who have they really killed off? Dendi triggers up the mech. There's a lot of Vipers out, a lot of Nagasaurans out there, but the Aegis Immortal already triggers. So the primary one's gone down, and Avor wants to try and turn a fight. He's got so many essence points shifted. This, he's just too big. The Slark is just way too big. Dendi will be shredded up by the Timbersaw. But Na'Vi will complete the job they came here to do. Avor actually managed to get closer to Cheshire Cat. He'll kill him off so quickly. 24 points of essence stolen. Picked up the Monkey King bar, and he'll actually grab it from the Dire shop. And there it is. GG, well played. They realize they'll be going to get mega'd up. They battled as hard as they possibly could. As at least it's a better lineup from Power Rangers this time around. It gave them levels of aggression. It allowed them to rotate across the map and be nice powerhouses. But there really was no plan B if Na'Vi got momentum into the mid game. And they did. Avor's got a lot of space to play around with. Sure, Dendi was shut down early on, but that's because he used the Naga and the Wisp to actually control him. And there was that moment around the 10 to 15 minute mark.